Hi everyone, today's video is going to be all about Chanel. I'll reveal the bag that I got in my last vlog, then I'll explain why I decided to return it, and then I'll unbox the bag that I got instead. I'll also touch the topic of price increases and rumors about new purchasing limits, particularly here in Europe, because I feel like the situation here is a little bit different than, for example, in the United States or Australia or even the United Kingdom. So you've been warned, today's video is going to be a chatty one. Okay, so let's start with the first bag. If you saw my last vlog, you already know that this was not a planned purchase. This year, I was actually very devoted on buying my very first Chanel Classic Flap, but being the irresponsible, impatient adult that I am, my foot slipped a number of times. So I kind of postponed and delayed making the big purchase. And then during my unexpected visit to Chanel, I actually noticed a different bag that had also been on my wish list for a very long time. So as I no longer have the bag because I already exchanged it, I will insert some footage from when I was trying it on at the boutique, because when I brought it home, I actually never properly opened it because I wanted to open it together with you guys. But then when I knew that I'm going to exchange it, I didn't really want to touch it more than I had to, because I knew that that bag is going to go back and it's going to have a new owner. So finally, the bag that I got is a seasonal black tweed single flap bag from the fall-winter 2021 collection. I had always wanted a Chanel tweed bag, and this one is simply stunning. I was immediately drawn to it, and when I tried it on, I loved it even more. The most unbelievable thing about this bag was the price. The price of this bag was 4,000 euros, which, considering the latest price increase, is exactly 2 times less than a medium classic flap. When I was at the boutique, I actually compared the size of it with a medium classic flap. I wasn't able to compare it with a small classic flap because they literally didn't have any, but the size with the medium classic flap was nearly identical. Even the length of the chain was exactly the same as on a medium Chanel classic flap, but there were 2 main differences with a Chanel classic flap, and the first one was that it was a single flap bag. And I believe that now all of the Chanel classic bags are always with a double flap. And the second big difference was the CC turn lock, because on the Chanel classics, the CC turn lock is solid metal. However, on this particular piece, it had leather intertwined in the hardware. So it was very, very similar to the Chanel 19 bag. And on top of that, it also had crystals all around the CCs. The crystals on the turn lock were actually the main reason why I had doubts about this bag in the first place, because I'm sure that we've all heard about the awful quality of Chanel's CC stud earrings with crystals. I feel like everyone who's had them has always complained about them. So I was immediately put off and quite scared to buy such an expensive bag with crystals. So I went home, slept on it, did some research about Chanel bags with crystals, and there wasn't actually a lot of information. So if you have a Chanel bag with crystals, please share in the comment section below what has been your experience. But as far as I was concerned, I wasn't able to find any like big complaints, because you hear, as I said before, a lot about the earrings, but nothing really about the bags. So I thought it would be kind of silly to miss out on this stunning bag only because of the crystals. So I went back to the boutique to see how it looks in daylight. It was absolutely stunning, so I got it. I thought to myself, I still have time to save up for a Chanel Classic Flap, because technically, the next price increase should be around spring or summer. And guess what? Guess what? Just a few days later, after I got that bag, rumors about the price increase were confirmed, not only in the United States, but worldwide. The price was supposed to go up by 15%. So that's approximately 1,000 euros for the second time this year. And that's when I knew I have to get my hands on a Chanel Classic Flap. So I messaged my SA, even though I already knew I was at the boutique just few days ago and they didn't have any small classic flaps. She confirmed that they only had a medium black lambskin classic flap with silver hardware. And that's pretty much the opposite of what I wanted. So all of my hopes for getting it for the old price were destroyed. Out of curiosity, I also asked her if there are going to be any changes to shopping limits, even though it doesn't really affect me because I don't buy a new Chanel bag every month. Unfortunately, right now I don't, but I asked her anyway, and as far as she was able to tell me, no changes are currently being implemented. I feel like the biggest change that they did is that they no longer keep bags on hold. And now let's talk a little more about the price. My limit, personally, for a Chanel Classic Flap was always the price of an Hermes Birkin 25. I hate comparing these two brands because it's like comparing celery with chocolate. They have nothing in common except for the fact that they're both food. And the same goes for Hermes and Chanel. The aesthetics for each brand are completely different. But at the same time, Hermes is just top of the food chain. And that's again, for me personally, a Birkin is top of the food chain. If you buy a Birkin in size 25 or 30 in a neutral color, and in Europe, as soon as you leave the boutique, your bag will triple in value. Yes, you heard me correctly. Not double, but literally triple. Of course, as I said, it's unfair to compare these two brands because it's not like you can just walk in any Hermes boutique and immediately get a Birkin like that. There are lines and games and purchase histories, but technically, if you look at it technically, the value of that bag is so much higher than Chanel's Classic Flap. And that's why my first reaction to the price increase was quite aggressive. I wanted to scratch off the Classic Flap from my wish list because after the price increase, the price of a small, mind you, small Chanel Classic Flap was 300 euros more than a Birkin 25 in Togo leather. I mean, from one side, I kind of get it because Chanel is trying really hard to be more exclusive. There are people that will tell you that they are having financial troubles. Maybe they are, maybe they're not. Only they know if they are. But I can only tell you what I see. And what I see is that resellers are snapping up the very exclusive colors in multiple quantities and then skyrocketing the prices of these bags on their websites. And there is nothing that Chanel hates more than resellers. And I believe that Chanel actually has had a few lawsuits with some of the reseller websites, so they take this seriously. But what they also see is that people are still buying these bags at these crazy prices. So from a business perspective, when you look at it, it makes sense that they increase the prices because the people are still buying these bags at insane prices. Of course, they're also taking a huge risk at losing a lot of their loyal clients. And I'm not talking about the VIPs. I am talking about people like me who maybe want to buy one bag a year or two Chanel bags a year. Those are the clients that I feel will feel the price increase the most. But other than that, Chanel is really not struggling to sell their classic flaps. Even after every price increase, their classic flaps still sell out like hotcakes. From my personal experience, I think it was maybe 2 months ago when my boutique had all the classic flaps, all the sizes, all the colors, even unicorn colors, you know, the shimmery ones, and all of them are sold out. Just a month and something later, all of them are gone. So of course Chanel is going to raise the prices to a ridiculous level. And this is where I started thinking that the price of a Chanel Classic Flap will never be less than it is right now. Unless you go pre-loved, but that's a whole other story, because finding a classic flap in a small or medium size in a neutral color on the pre-loved market under retail price has become impossible. And personally, I wanted my first holy grail Chanel Classic Flap fresh from the boutique, so I had to accept that the current price is what it is, and it will never be less, because in 12 months, or based on the recent experiences, in even 6 months or just 4 months, there will be another price increase. And since it is a holy grail bag for me, I know that it would always be on my mind, it would always bother me. So I really liked the perspective of one of my fellow YouTubers, Dani, who said that basically, because at this point Chanel price increases are pretty much inevitable, it's almost like right now Chanel is on sale. It's a way of looking at things as a glass half full. So I thought about it a lot, and I knew it's going to be a bag that I'm gonna get my use out of. I knew it's going to be a bag that I'll want to keep forever. So when it came to the choice of the tweed bag and the Holy Grail Classic Flap, I was definitely leaning towards the Holy Grail Classic Flap. And finally, the last thing that convinced me to exchange the bag was the fact that seasonal bags will always be less expensive than the classics. They are slowly and steadily increasing in price, but much less aggressively than the classics. So since I had already spent more than half of what I needed for a Chanel Classic Flap on the tweed bag, I thought I'll just add what's missing and honestly get it over with. Even though I would have loved to keep both of these bags, I simply could not justify keeping them both, and I didn't want to pay a single penny more for a Chanel Classic Flap, and I also didn't want to worry about price increases anymore, because I have my holy grail bag. Now what happens, happens. If I can afford to buy more, great. If I can't, I have my holy grail. Okay, I have been talking so much that I forgot to do the unboxing. I'm so sorry, guys. Let's finally open this. Here we have black tissue paper and the signature Chanel Classic Flap dust bag. Okay, guys, are you ready? It is the Chanel Classic Flap in size small, in black caviar leather and gold hardware. Here she is in all her glory, and I have to say, zero regrets. I absolutely adore her. Do you want to take off the sticker with me? Fresh from the factory, and here goes the sticker. I'm sure that everyone is already familiar with this bag, but I'll just quickly run through it. It has a double flap, burgundy interior, and then we have three little pockets. Then there's also a front compartment, a little back pocket, and a small zip compartment for Coco Chanel's love letters. My bag was made in France, and it also has the authenticity plate, because they no longer have the authenticity cards with holograms. I mean, having this bag is such a dream come true. And I know that there will be people who are going to say, you are crazy buying a Chanel Classic Flap at these prices, they are not worth it, they are such worse quality than they used to be, and all of that. But these are usually the people that have been buying the classic flaps for more than 10 years, and they lived through the times of when a Chanel Classic Flap used to cost, what, maybe 2,000 euros? But for us, people that were not able to afford it back then, or simply were not into luxury handbags back then, we never saw that price. And it's a price that we have to accept we will never see again. Even in the pre-loved market, you will not find a Chanel Classic Flap in a neutral color under 2000 euros. Even the bags that are completely destroyed, they now cost more than 2000 euros because people buy them and then they take them to bag spas. The only thing that makes me sad just a little bit is that I always thought that this would be a bag that I'll buy from the very first Chanel boutique in Paris. I always had that dream to get the beautiful white packaging and, you know, the whole Paris experience. But because of the consistent price increases, I don't know when will I go to Paris. And by the time I actually get to Paris, who knows what the price of this would be. So it's sad that I kind of had to let that dream go. But at the same time, there are so many other things that I can buy from that boutique. So I'm very grateful to have her and I'm going to love her. I'm going to cherish her. So I'm super, super excited to finally have my holy grail bag in my collection. Okay guys, so that's it for my video today. I hope that you enjoyed it and I hope that you found it useful. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I do love talking about fashion. So let's stay in touch and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys, stay safe.